This will demonstrate the flow of execution in a simple program which detects if a number is prime or not. To begin with, the program will reserve space for an integer. We will refer to that space with the name num. This space will still contain whatever random data was there before, so we will need to initialize num before we use it. We refer to reserving that space and giving it a name as declaring a variable. On line 6, the program will output the text, "Please enter a positive integer," to the console, followed by a new line. On line 7, the program will stop until the user inputs a value. In this run-through, we will input the value 1. When we do this, the program will store the value 1 in the variable num. So we've replaced the random data in num with the value 1. The program will then move to the next line, where it will reserve space for a Boolean variable. Name it prime, and assign it the value of true. This will essentially all happen in a single step, as far as the program is concerned. The next line encountered is the if condition. It checks if num is equal to 1. If so, it executes the next line of code, which assigns the variable prime a value of false. From there, the program encounters the for loop. The first thing it will do is reserve space for an integer I and assign it a value of 2. Next, it will see if I is less than num. In this case, 2 is not less than 1, so the loop condition is false. When it is false, it skips the rest of the code block and does not increment I. It will then hit the if condition. In this case, prime was set to false, so it skips the code immediately following the if condition and executes the code in the else condition. This outputs the variable num, followed by the string is not prime, to the console. The program hits the return statement, which causes it to exit. In the next run-through, we will input a value of 5 when prompted. Again, it will reserve space for an int called num with some unknown value. Then it prompts the user for input, and we enter the value 5, which is assigned to be the value of the variable num. Then it will declare a bool called prime with a value of true. Next, it will check if num is equal to 1. 5 is not equal to 1, so it will skip the following code. Then it will hit the for loop. It will create an integer I, assign it a value of 2. It will see if I is less than 5. If so, it will execute the code in the following code block. In this case, it will check if 5 mod 2 is equal to 0. That condition is not true, so it does not execute the line of code setting prime to false. At this point, it executes the I++ code, which increments I to 3. Now it checks if 3 is less than 5. It is, so it checks if 5 mod 3 equals 0. That condition is false, so it skips setting prime to false and increments I to 4. The loop condition I less than num is still true. 5 mod 4 is not 0, so prime remains true. I is incremented to 5. I is no longer less than 5, so it does not execute the loop again and skips past it to the if statement. Now that prime is true, the if part is executed and the else part is ignored. This prints out that 5 is prime. The program then exits. Finally, let's look at a non-prime number larger than 1. So we will input 6 in this run-through. The same first steps happen, except we input 6 as a value. Things get different at the for loop. 2 is less than 6, so the contents of the loop are executed. 6 mod 2 is 0, so the line setting prime to false is executed. After getting to the end of the code in the loop, I is incremented. 3 is still less than 6, so the loop runs again. 6 mod 3 is 0, so prime is set to false again, but this changes nothing. This continues until I is incremented to 6, causing the for loop to end. Prime is false, so the else condition is triggered, printing out that 6 is not prime, and the program exits.